Welcome to module 8.1, and now we move on to the next phase, which is basically the JAC programming language. So just to recap what we have done, we have created a machine called hack, and this had an machine instructions. Now this machine instructions were in binary. So, there was an hack mnemonic. We wrote a assembler which will convert from hack mnemonic to binary. Then we defined a virtual machine, and we have written a virtual machine interpreter which will convert from virtual machine ISA from this virtual machine to hack mnemonic. Now we are defining the high level programming, which is JAC. Now this will be compiled. So we will be writing programming in JAC, and that will be compiled into the virtual machine, and that virtual machine interpreter will make it into assembly. Assembler will convert that mnemonic to binary, and then you can execute on hack. So this is the entire sequence that we are going to follow now. Now, what we will be learning in this module 8.1 and 8.2 is to basically understand how do you program in this JAC. So, you have some human thought in mind, and you want to just convert it into a JAC program. It is an abridged version. JAC is nothing but an abridged version of Java. How do you go and write that thought in JAC? So, we will, because before you start interpreting the language, compiling the language, before you start writing the compiler for the language, it is very important that you understand the constructs of the language. And the best way to understand the construct of the language is to understand programming using that language. So, we will see a set of programs and show you how it works before we proceed on to how do you write the compiler. Okay. Now, I am using the slides that are available in the nan2tetris.org website. So, you can download the slides from the project folder there in the nan2tetris.org for your further reference. Right. So, the way we go about this entire lecture is that we will start looking at high level programming, then we will look at some amount of application development using this high level programming, and then finally, we will end this module 8 with the specification of the JAC language. Now, let us now start looking at this. The first program anybody wants to write is the hello world program. Now, in JAC, like C, there is a routine called main, function called main, and that will be the first function that you execute. If you are looking at other things like Java or any other C++, you need not even go through this lecture, you will understand this lecture very quickly. But I am doing this lecture for people who have not studied object-oriented programming languages like C++ or Java, but they are good in C, of course, right. So, now, as in C, that small main, that function main will execute first. Now, in Java, in JAC, right, there is always a class called main, which starts with capital M, and inside that class, there is going to be a small main function called small main. Always this main dot main will execute first, right. So, this is the basic thing. Now, for a quick understanding of what a class is, you would have studied struct in C, right. The struct in C has some equivalence to class, though it is not fully equivalent, the struct in C is having some equivalence to class. What is struct? Struct is basically a template, and you instantiate that template again and again to create several objects, right. Now, what is stored inside the struct are only data items. Class is also a template, you instantiate that class again and again to create many objects. The difference between struct and class is, in struct we only store the data items like integers, floating points, etcetera. In class, we store the data items. In addition, we also store certain functions and methods by which you can manipulate those data. So, that is the difference between struct and class, right. So, the the Hello World program always has a class, any program always has a class called main with M capital, as you see here. And then inside that main, you have another function void main small, okay, right. So, always you will execute main dot small main. So, when you start executing main dot small main here, when you compile this program and execute, we will start executing main dot small main. And what it will do is, it does these two things: do output dot print string hello world, do output dot println, and it will return. Return back to whom? The operating system itself. And this is the end of this. So, this do output dot print screen print string is equivalent to your printf statement, and do output dot print line is new line character here. So, and so what we have understood, so when, so what will be the output when you compile this using the JAC compiler, which is available as a part of your project, the output will be just hello world here, right. So, this is how this works. So, what we have learned here, we have learned that there is a class, the entire JAC is based on classes. There is always a class called main with capital M. Inside that class main, there should be a function void small main, and that will be the first function that will execute, and that will call the other functions and other classes, instantiate other classes, etc. And then the way I can output anything is, I can use this do output dot print string. I can print any string I want, and I can also use new line output dot println, and it should be do output dot print string, do output dot println and return. So, who is going to provide me with this print string and println? Essentially, this output output class. So, this output is a class, and print string is a method function inside that class. Like main is a class, capital main is a class, and a small main is a function within that class. Inside this, output is a class, print string is a function within that class, and similarly our here also output println. So, who is going to provide me this class called output, which has all these functions inside? The operating system is going to provide me, like how printf and scanfs are provided by the operating system in the case of C programming. Here this output class, which contains those functions print string and println etc., here is going to be provided by the operating system. So, this is an understanding of the Hello World program. So, what are the things here? All the white spaces are ignored, and these are the different ways by which I can put a command, right. So, there are three types of comments. This is called an application. API stands for application programmer interface. So, slash star star hello world program slash star, this is an API block comment. Then I could have just a simple block comment, which is this, and I could have just inline comment like this, right. So, I could have three types of comments as you see here, and then this white space, always all the white spaces are ignored. They are only treated as demarcators of characters. Now, let us take this next program, right. So, this is function void main. So, again there is a class main, function void main. Now, we are trying to introduce more syntax here, more. So, I am declaring an array a, small a, var array a. Now, in JAC, these arrays are not typed, so I can store anything in that array, right. But they are going to be 16 bit variables, so I can store integers, I can store anything, I can store strings, whatever you want, but 16 bits is the size of every element here. Var array a, var int length, var int I comma sem. So, I have declared an array a, I have declared length, I have declared I comma sem. Now, let length equal to, do it as the same. In C, we just say length equal to something, but in JAC, we say let length equal to keyboard dot read int how many numbers. So, keyboard is a class. Inside that class, there is something called read int, which will read an integer from the keyboard. So who is providing this keyboard thing? The operating system is providing us, right? So keyboard.readint will read and how many numbers. So once this statement gets executed, how many numbers question will come on the screen. Then you press 3 and press enter, right? So 3 or whatever, in this case 3. Now it will go and say, let A equal to array dot new of length. So it will create an array of length 3, right? Of so A0 array, that will be A0, A1 and A2. It will create array of size 3. So this is equivalent to the malloc statement that you see, M-A-L-L-O-C, malloc statement that you see in the C. Okay. Now what we do? So we have then we do while I is less than length, let A equal to keyboard dot read int enter a number. Sum equal to sum plus AI. Let I equal to I plus 1. This goes on. So this loop will print this enter a number, say 3 times in this case, because you said length is 3. So it will, you will enter 12, 8 and 5. So that will be stored in A of 0, A of 1 and A of 2, as you see here. I sum this up. Okay. Then after finishing this while loop, we say do output dot print string the averages and do output dot print in sum by length. Return. So this will be 25 by 3, which is the integer part is 8. So the average is 8. So this is how this particular function works, and this is how the input output happens on the screen. Right. And then you return back. So this is basically this. So what we have learnt here is the notion of what is array, how to declare an array, a while loop is there, how to use an array, how to read input from a keyboard, and finally how the while loop statement that you have seen here, and the malloc statement that you have seen here. How to declare an array, construct an array, read input from the keyboard, and how to use the array, and right, using how to allocate space for that array equivalent to malloc, how to use the array, and some statements like some arithmetic statement like sum by length, etc. Right. So this is part of the procedure program. So we are learning more and more syntax as we see here. You can type these programs and then compile and see. I'll show you how to go and do that. Right. So to sum up, a JAC program is a collection of one or more JAC classes, one of which must be named capital main, and the main class must have at least one function named main. It should have at least one function, and that function should be named main, and the program's entry point is always main dot main. Right. So there are different data types for JAC. There are primitive data types like int, char and boolean. So we have just var int length, we could have var char whatever, it will be a character, and we could have var boolean sum, right, it could be a boolean here. So these are the three primitive data types. We have only seen integer here. Then there are certain class types which are basically array, string, etc. And there can be additional abstract data types can be defined and used as needed. So as of now, the basic data types are int, char and boolean, and then we have class types which are provided by the operating system, which we have one of them we have used. This is array. This array is a class, and so the moment I declare an array, I can have array dot new. New is a function inside that class which will create a space for storing that many number of elements in that array, etc. So similarly, I could have also string. Okay. Then you have this. This is a flow control because I have while statement here. So I have while, I have do statement, and I also have if and if else. Right. We have not used if and if else so far, but we can use if and if else. So let us go and look at the array. Array is actually implemented as part of the standard class library, and the Jack arrays are actually not typed. So it is a class, and you can, this is a malloc equivalent, and this is the way you can use an array. Similarly, keyboard, the OS services that you see are keyboard.readint, output.printstring, output.printint, and many more things. These are all equivalent to the scanf and printf type of statements. Right. Now, with this we will start looking at what we call as the object-oriented programming. We will now basically go into some of the details. Before proceeding further into this object-oriented programming details, we will quickly look at the project 8, a part of your project 9, where you will, we will show you how things are basically working, right. Thank you.